My name is Siddharaj Bhatta and this is my email address. In this video, I'm going to talk about five tricky but simple GRE quant questions. These questions are very much simple, but in the time pressure in the exam, we can make a mistake. So the first question is about the right angle isosceles triangle. In a right angle isosceles triangle ABC, point B is the right angle and AC is hypotenuse. And this is a quantitative comparison question. We have to compare these two quantities, slope of hypotenuse AC and minus 1. So now, if we think of this triangle this way only, so this is a right angle isosceles triangle. This is point B, this is point A, and this is point C. Now these two angles will measure 45 degrees and its slope is minus 1. And we can select option C, which is not true in this case. For this, let us consider a right angle triangle which is isosceles also, like this, right angled and isosceles. Now in this case its slope is positive number, positive 1. We can also think of a right angle isosceles triangle in this way too. So this is point B and the slope of AC is 0 in this case. So our answer is D. Question number 2 is about a square. ABCD is a square. We have to compare the absolute value of the slope of the diagonal with 1. So if we think of a square this way only, the slope of this diagonal is negative 1, whereas the slope of this diagonal is positive 1. And the absolute value is positive 1. And we may immediately select answer C. But again, this is not true. For this, consider this square in this form. Here, its slope is almost 0 and its slope is almost infinite. So the slope of the diagonal of a square can be any number and our answer is D. Question number 3. This question is very simple again. We have to compare 9 with this sum. So most of the students, they get confused about the square root. They take the values of under root 16 to be positive 4 and negative 4, and the value of under root 25 to be negative 5 and positive 5. So in this case, the answer is D. Unfortunately, this is not the correct answer, because any number that is under this sign, square root sign, this is always a positive number. So remember, any number inside the square root sign is always positive number. So 16 has two square roots. One is the positive square root. This is under 16. Another is the negative square root, which is minus times under root 16. So this is plus 4 and this is minus 4. So remember here that the number inside the square root is always positive. So in this case, this is positive 4, positive 5, this is positive 9. So our answer is C. Question number 4 is about a ratio. Ratio of two quantities is 3:4. If we add 5 to each of them, what will be the ratio of the quantities. So for example, if we add 5 to both of them, the answer B will come up. And if we are running out of time in the exam, we may immediately select B. But unfortunately, this is not the correct answer, because if we take another example, 6/8, so another ratio appears, that is region is C. If we take further examples, the ratios will be different. So since this is a single choice question, means only one of the answer will be correct, but V and C cannot be correct at the same time. And now if we add 5 to these numbers, the ratio will be 7/9. So the ratios are different in each example, and our answer is E cannot be determined from the given information. So our last question is about median. In the case of median of 5 numbers, which of the following cannot affect the value of the median? So to explain this, I've taken a simple example here. 5 numbers which are arranged in ascending order, and the median number is 25. Now take the first option, doubling each number. In this case, 25 will be doubled to 50, and the value of median will be affected, and this is not our correct answer. So option B is a little bit confusing. If we increase the smallest number, for example 10 to 11, the value of median will not be affected, whereas if we increase 10 to 100, the value of median would shift to 30. So this can affect the value of median, and this is not also our answer. Decreasing the largest number, again the same case. If you decrease 35 to 26, 27, the value of median would remain same. However, if you decrease 35 to less than 25, for example 21, 10, 2, the value of median will be changed. So this is also not our answer. So option D says that increasing the largest number only. So to whatever larger number you increase this 35, the median will not change in this case. So D is the correct answer. And sorry, I have missed one phrase here. Select all that apply. Select all that apply. So here E is also the correct answer, because to whatever small number you reduce 10, the value of median remains the same. So thank you for watching this video, and please subscribe to my channel for watching a complete set of videos regarding GRE quant preparation. Thank you.